Everyone, and welcome to this information video. Today, I am going to talk about the cult, that is the Church of Scientology. Because of the restrictions of time in this video, I shall have to keep it very brief, but I will try to cover as much of the more important points as I can. So, what is Scientology? Well, let us start with the official word of the Church itself. The Church says Scientology is about the individual man or woman. Its goal is to bring an individual to a sufficient understanding of himself and his life, and free him to improve conditions in the way that he sees fit. The number of actual members of Scientology is hard to ascertain accurately. It is a secretive cult, after all. However, it has become very apparent in recent years that the membership has dwindled quite considerably, and it is not uncommon to see many virtually empty churches and offices worldwide. Thankfully, it appears that the public is becoming wise to the fact that Scientology is a dangerous cult. Here is a quote from a UK High Court judge, Justice Leighty. Scientology is both immoral and socially obnoxious. It is corrupt, sinister and dangerous. It is corrupt because it is based on lies and deceit and has as its real objective money and power. There are dozens of similar quotes from other judges and court-appointed employees. Of course, the Church of Scientology would have us all believe that the numbers are now even better than ever, despite many independent reports to the contrary. Recently, they have put their PR campaign into overdrive as a result of the Anonymous movement, but more of Anonymous later. Scientology is a cult, controlled by an abusive money-orientated management. The cult is all about money and power, nothing else. It's true that there are many low-level Scientologists who are good people, who genuinely think they are helping. Unfortunately, the reality of the matter is that these people are being used to help generate more members and yet more money for the cult. People have the right to believe in anything they wish, even the flying spaghetti monster. If it makes you happy and you are not causing harm to anyone, then we have no objection to that. However, when that religion starts to abuse its power, its members, and anyone that speaks out against it, then it becomes vitally important to highlight these abuses in order to protect the innocent. Rather than give hope, as many legitimate religions do, Scientology tries to sell you hope. Unlike all legitimate religions, Scientology is a closed book, apart from the bare essentials. For example, Christians can study all aspects of their religion and their Bible is public knowledge and open to all for free. Not so with Scientology. To advance yourself in their phony science fiction-based religion, you have to pay and pay big money, many thousands of pounds in most cases. Scientology was created by the American science fiction writer L. Ron Hubbard and came as a result of his 1950 book, Dianetics. The first Scientology church was established at the end of 1953. Scientology is based on extraordinarily crazy ideas which seem to defy logical and clear thinking. However, Hubbard was a great showman and, as was established at a later date, a great liar and con man too. It's easy to understand how certain people could be sucked into the cult thinking that they were going to improve themselves and the lives of others. It's hard to fathom how anyone could fall for such insanity, but they do. You could almost be forgiven for thinking it was a poorly written story by a third-rate science fiction writer. Most of the courses, which again have to be paid for, aim to help you rid yourself of these alien souls which are supposedly causing humans all their problems. Scientologists call these alien lost souls thetans. Once you rid yourself of all your thetans, then, you are declared clear, with the ultimate goal being cleared theta clear, the explanation of which is so incredibly dumb and unbelievable I can't bring myself to explain it without laughing uncontrollably. Needless to say, there has never been shown any real evidence of even one single Scientologist attaining this state, despite what the church tells its members. Now let's get back to L. Ron Hubbard. In later years, Hubbard began making statements to the effect that any writer who really wished to make money should stop writing and develop a religion. In fact, fellow science fiction writer John Campbell wrote that Hubbard told him, "I'm going to invent a religion that's going to make me a fortune. I'm tired of writing for a penny a word." Another writer and historian, Sam Moskowitz, heard Hubbard make an almost identical statement. Hubbard was found dead in a wretched state early in 1986, and tests on his body fluids revealed he had been injecting Visteril, a psychiatric tranquilizer. A full autopsy was not performed on Hubbard's body, as he expressly forbid it in his will, as it was against his religion. There are many people that firmly believe Hubbard was actually murdered, and the lack of an autopsy doesn't help to quell these rumors. So, who is in charge of Scientology today? The chairman of the board of the Religious Technology Center, which is the company that controls Scientology, is David Miscavige. Miscavige took over from L. Ron Hubbard shortly after his death. Miscavige's self-promotion took place under very suspicious circumstances. Many people, including some top management in Scientology, believe that Miscavige forced and threatened his way into the position. Known for his fiery temper, there are many reports about Miscavige regularly giving beatings to Scientology members when things aren't going his way. Because of the absolute power he wields, it isn't surprising that most people just take the abuse and remain silent, though there are ex-Scientologists who have written about the abuse they personally received from Miscavige. A quick search on the internet will even reveal affidavits to this effect. Miscavige is a short man. I estimate him to be just over 3 feet tall. His short stature is probably one of the reasons for his overcompensation in the power department. Miscavige was best man at Tom Cruise's wedding. Tom Cruise is one of the more famous supporters of the cult, and Miscavige counts him as one of his great friends. Interestingly, Miscavige hosted a $100,000 birthday bash for Tom on the Scientology-owned ship, the Free Winds, which, unknown to Mr. Cruise, was awash with dangerous blue asbestos at the time, and still is. The deadly blue asbestos had first been found and reported way back in 1987, and to this day has not been fully decontaminated. At the time this video was made, the Free Winds has been sealed off and confined pending decontamination. It remains to be seen if Miscavige was aware of the asbestos problem, but it would be incredible if not. Lawrence Woodcraft, the architect overseeing the renovation and the one who discovered the blue asbestos, reported it directly to David Miscavige's wife, Shelley Miscavige. Miscavige is said to have a huge ego and little patience for those who do not provide great results and fast. Let's see how Miscavige might just see himself, and for this I hope you will excuse the grandeur of me presenting this short segment to you full screen.